heard was these lectures on experimentation in Baroque music and experiments with tonality. I immediately thought, yeah, I have to play the Labyrinth by Marianne Marie. Why? It's a very famous piece of him, already noticed in the 18th century. Yeah, Marianne Marie wrote such remarkable pieces about La Gamme, which is a trio sonata based on a scale. So the theme is a scale. But then also the microstructure of the piece is a scale. So it starts with a piece in C, then in D, then in E, and so on. So it's already quite remarkable. In the Labyrinth, he makes a piece that is completely crazy, actually. It goes everywhere. And it starts with a modulation that goes until D sharp major. From D sharp major, he turns the D sharp into an E flat and modulates to C minor. So, very far. But also, he experiments a lot with like sudden dissonances, yeah, all kinds of strange ornamentation also. Well, that's quite common for Marais. He's very clear about some elements of ornamentation. So what we find actually almost only with Marais is the use of the enflé, which is a little E he puts where he wants to the tone to swell. So you would put it kind of things. And he changes also the location, so it can be in the beginning of the note or a bit further. So it really determines very well what he has, what he wants. Also, you have the infamous two-finger vibrato. It's not because I'm extremely nervous, it's written down in the score. And another sign for a one-finger vibrato, so also that he determines very precisely, and even in one place, he used it also in some other pieces, but there is this glide over half a tone. It's also something hard to find with other composers, but we find it in some pieces by Marais. Also, he determines if he has chords, whether he wants them arpeggiated or in all at once. So there is a whole passage where we have to play on three strings without arpeggiating, so it's quite a forceful playing. But it's a labyrinth. I hope we don't lose each other in the labyrinth.